Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here today. We're looking at archaic words in the NIV. This comes from a tremendous author, Lawrence Vance. He owns Vance Publications, which is a great publishing. You need to just check it out. He's a huge Greek scholar, Hebrew scholar, libertarian, Ludwig von Mises Institute guy. But he wrote archaic words in the King James Version. But one of the things he points out, because of his voluminous research, is that the New International Version uses tons of archaic words. And it's not just the NIV. We've done a video on the New King James, the New Revised Standard, the New American Standard, doing the same thing, using all kinds of archaic language. And oftentimes using archaic language when the King James language is simpler. So one of the justifications for a new Bible translation is, well, it needs to be easier to read because language changes over time. Well, first of all, that's a fallacy. I wonder how often is Chinese changed, you know, Hindi. Funny, I can read writings from the 1600s in English, 1500s in English, you know. So just tons. Let me just read some of these to you. That NIV hard word, like alcove. Well, I mean, I kind of know what an alcove is, but I don't see it. But in the King James, it's little chamber, Ezekiel 40:13. Armlets. Well, I don't use armlets every day. That's what the NIV says. And the King James has changed. So you might say, well, what's accuracy? Well, the King James will be very accurate in this. Blunted. Well, I mean, you might use the term blunted every so often, but cut in pieces is how the King James says that in Psalm 58:7. Blustering. I rarely use the term blustering unless I'm listening to a liberal or something. But no, I shouldn't say that. Job 8:2, but in the King James, it's strong. You can see it doesn't even mean the same thing. Burnished. Is an NIV word in Daniel 10:6, burnished or polished. Well, I wouldn't say I'm burnishing this, I'm polishing this. Colonnade, let's step out onto the colonnade. Well, I would normally use the King James word porch, porch. In Exodus 28:20, I probably wouldn't say filigree, I would say enclosings. In Genesis 14:1, I wouldn't say goyim, I would say nations. Hades, of course, you know, there's a lot of videos out on how the New International Version and many modern versions take hell out, but Hades instead of hell. Harrowing, I don't use harrowing, it may be a harrowing experience. But Isaiah 28:24, the King James would say, break the clods. Impaled in the NIV versus hanged in Ezra 6:11. Song of Solomon says tresses in Psalm 7:5. The King James would say galleries. Hosea 4:13 would talk about the terebinth. How many of you know what a terebinth is without looking? But most of us know what an elm is, elm trees. Okay, so that's King James say elms. Stadia in Revelation 14:20, instead of furlong, you know, when they run the Kentucky Derby or something, they're not talking about stadia, they're talking about furlongs. Sistrum, what's a sistrum? That's not your sister when you mispronounce it. A sistrum is cornets in King James. How about a satrap? A satrap is a lieutenant in the King James. In the NIV, a sachet is a bundle in the King James. Ravining, not ravening, but ravening. Jeremiah 2:30 is destroying in the King James. Pinions in Deuteronomy 32:11 in the NIV is now wings. I think wings is much easier to read. Porphyry, what does porphyry mean? And I'm not talking about the ancient historian. Porphyry. Esther 1:6 is red in the King James. I think red is like a lot easier to read. How about portent in the NIV versus wonder? Portico versus porch. Poultice versus lump. Praetorium versus common hall. Prefix NIV versus governors. Proconsul as opposed to deputy. Profligate instead of glutton. Qualm instead of fear. rabble in the NIV versus mixed multitude, repointing as opposed to sharpen, and reposes instead of rest. So, like, if their goal was for ease of reading, didn't they just blow it? A lot of, you know, they just, what, did they deliberately just put a lot of difficult words like a wadi? What's a wadi? I know what a wadi is because I've studied biblical archaeology. But in the King James, it's a river. So you can just kind of see that. Now, not only that, did they change a lot of easy words that are usually synonymous with much more difficult words in the NIV. And the NIV is over 60,000 words shorter, so they just destroyed the text. Just Satan couldn't have done a much better job there. But, and I'm not saying the people that worked on it were Satanists or anything like that. I think they might have just been misguided, and maybe with good purpose. But now look at some of the words that people consider archaic in the King James that are retained in the NIV. So then they had the opportunity to say, well, we're going to make this easier to read, and they just retained it. So not only did they make easy words more difficult, then they made what some would consider difficult words and left them there. So, you know, just trying to dispel some myths, a lot of myths on Bible translations. We have to deal in facts. I'm kind of a radical empiricist. So I go where the facts lead, and these are just facts. So, God bless. I love you. Just fall in love with the Bible. Fall in love with the God of the Bible. Be saved in Jesus' name. God love you.